Okay, what I want to do today is demonstrate how to refresh data within a PowerPivot, and then in the following demonstration after this I'll show you how to update data. So refreshing data is useful when customer records have been updated and the underlying format or structure of the data source hasn't been changed. So that's an example of refreshing, but when that underlying structure does change, you need to actually do an update, which is slightly different. So this is the data we have, and what I'm going to do is basically do the equivalent of what I'm going to do is change some of these underlying records in the data source. So this is probably the equivalent of, say, a customer record being updated from one day to another, but this will just be, I'll replace this city information, I'll replace city with metro, city, metro, replace all. Okay, let's let it go through and do it. I'll close that down, I'll save that. Okay, so this is the actual where we want the data to go. So at the moment it's sitting within a table, so city, non-city, and what we'll do is refresh the data here with this icon. So you can either refresh all, which will refresh all the connections. We've only got one connection in this case, so we can just click refresh here, see what's wrong with the error. Doesn't have the column requested. Okay, so city, non-city has changed. So if we go back to the raw customer data, so we see that the top's changed. So we'll just go change that city, non-city. Typical sort of little bug that you get within Excel, or a little thing that can catch out. So hopefully this will resolve the issue. So we'll go back to the PowerPivot window, click refresh. Okay, and now it's done that. Okay, so we can then click through to the workbook, which has the city, non-city. So what we need to do is just go data, refresh all here. And then that's updated it to metro, non-metro. So that is fantastic. So we can then click on the, we're going to slice and dice the data accordingly. So nice and simple.